de los números pegados que me toquen la cadena de security.
Ok, muchas gracias. Por tanto, me voy a discutir. It's about, I'm going to comment what are the main tools in the containers ecosystem. The main tools that have been used containers and in Docker security. This is the main points that I will talk. I will make an introduction to container security. And I will center in the two main container solutions, like Linux containers and Docker. Also, I will talk about the security pipeline and what are the main container threats that we can find in container ecosystems. And finally, the a set of tools that we can find for auditing container image and auditing the host where we are running our image. Well, if we try to compare virtualization and containers, basically the main difference between these two architectures is that containers are isolated and share the operating system, libraries, and so on. In Docker, for example, we have the Docker engine and in other system we have another engine for running applications over the same operating system. Well, if we try to compare, we have in visualization we have different kernels, and in containers we have the single kernel, a single kernel, and which made the containers are what is called a syscall. Syscall are the for communication between containers, and provides containers provide other solutions, other security solutions that I'm commenting now, that provides the security of these systems. These are the basic security mechanisms that provide containers. In general, we can see that provides many solutions like capabilities, the classical Linux capabilities are. We can find in Linux containers and in Docker, for example, the C groups, namespaces, root file system, all these capabilities. We can all the main features that are implemented in containers. I will go in details. For example, namespaces basically what provides an isolated view of the system where processes cannot see other processes in other containers. Basically, each container also gets its own network stack. And the other feature are cgroups. Basically, is the main kernel feature that provides limiting and isolating the resources of the machine, that's the CPU, memory, network, and basically the process that are running in our machine. And Linux capabilities, basically what this does is divides the privilege of root into distinct units and a smaller group of privileges. Linux container, for example, this is one of the first solutions. All these features that I comment, like namespaces, kernel capabilities and so on, Linux containers provide all these features. Also, what another solutions like for security, like Apartmore and say Linux, and basically these are the main features that provide the Linux containers for security. Linux containers provide basically with the LXC command we can start a single process in a container, or with the LXC start we can mount a specific operating system with applications and dependencies in that image. for limiting resources in any containers, we can use the configuration for Linux containers. For example, if we want to limit the memory usage or the CPU, we can use specific commands, specific configuration for configuring these use cases. For example, if we want to limit the memory, what we can to do is in this example we can see that we have we are checking the free memory in our machine, and when we execute the use container over this machine, we can see that we can limit the memory. With the limit those memory configuration, we can execute the container limiting the memory in a nice way. Docker, for example, provides in a similar way. In a similar way that we have the lse star command, we have the Docker run. The Docker run provides also basically the Docker container is a combination of C groups, namespaces, and image, and all these components provide what we are running our Docker container or Docker image. This is the classical container pipeline. When we are working with Docker, we have a Docker client with the commands that we can find in Docker, all the commands, and we have also the Docker the Docker server. This is where we're executing the Docker daemon. The Docker daemon is the main process that Docker uses for executing the image in the container that we are running. And this pipeline is complete with a communication with the repositories. The main repositories that we have is the public repository that we have in Docker is the Docker Hub, but we can also have our own repositories, private repositories in our organization or in our servers. We can in Docker Hub are the main we can find the main image from operating systems, servers, and so on. And this image, when we are downloading this image, the execution of this image originates what is called a container. A container basically is an image that is running in your Docker host. Basically, the Docker image, are layers that when you are pulling an image from a public or private repository, you are downloading an image that in reality is a file that contains many layers. Depending your application, for example, if we are downloading we have the base image, for example, with Ubuntu, for example, or with other system, system or server, and what we do for working with Docker is adding applications, adding layers over the main base image. From the security point of view, Docker provides, as I commented before, isolation via kernel namespaces, additional layer of security with more and Linux. Each container gets its own network stack for communications, and also provides a control group for resource limiting. And other interesting features, like for example, when we are pulling from Docker Hub, this is an interesting features that created in 1.8 version that is called Docker Content Trust, that we can verify the integrity of the image. This feature, what it does is checking the checksum of the image when we are pulling from Docker Hub. And in this way, we can verify that that image is consistent with the repository that we are running. In this example, we can see that for using this feature, we have to enable a Docker Content Trust environment variable, and in a easy way we can verify that when we are downloading, we are pulling from the Docker Hub public repository the Python image, we are verifying that information. This feature basically what is that is protecting that from that you are downloading an image that is not that has not modified, and is an image with a full integrity from a security point of view. We have also a new command in new versions of Docker. We have the Docker Trust command. It's an experimental way we can manage in another way our Docker image. We do this command. We can manage the keys from signing Docker image. We can manage entities to check who is signing the Docker image. This is an experimental command, but you can try for checking this kind of security. Also, Docker provides what is called Docker capabilities. Basically, capabilities is a Linux kernel feature. And Docker gets this feature for implementing in Docker. Basically, a capability is an Unix action that a user can perform. The main we have a lot of capabilities that by default are loaded when you install Docker and you run the first time. You have by default capabilities, but you can, for example, restrict these capabilities. In this example, we can see that we have the capabilities that are enabled by default when we are running a container, but we can limit to restrict the default configuration that provides Docker by default. For doing this, we can use the cap drop flag for restrict this configuration. In this example, we can see that we are dropping the net row function. That what this does is basically restrict the network function, restrict that for example and disable the ping function in our container, and in general functions related with the network functions. In general, what is container security? Container security, if we try to go in general, for example, with the main ideas that we have is that it's about limiting and controlling the attack surface on the kernel. This means that we have the least privilege principle, that where we have this principle, it says that the best practice at this point is not run processes in a container as root to avoid root access from attackers, enable illusionary space, rules file system as read only so that attackers cannot override data or save malicious scripts to file, and in general limiting the kernel calls, the kernel system calls that a container can make to reduce the potential attack surface. This is the main idea in container security. For example, this is a flag that we can enable in containers. in Docker, for example, is the read-only flag that we can use for avoiding that an attacker can override the image, creating files, and in general modify that image. Also, solutions that we have is, for example, Second provides limiting the system calls with a restricted system calls based on a policy file. And now we will see an example. Basically, Second block and limit things like kernel manipulation, executing mount points, chain permissions, chain the owner, and C groups. This is an example where we define a policy JSON with the commands with the system calls that we want to disable to block when we are executing the Docker our Docker image. Basically, we can use the security of flag, and as a parameter, we put the policy JSON file, and in this way, we are blocking, for example, the commands like chmod, chown, encadir, for example, and in this way, we can see that we can block this kind of command and system calls. When for the security point of view, we have two kind of tools for securing, for example, the Docker host, that is the Docker the machine where Docker is running. We have tools like Docker Ben Security. This allows auditing our Docker environment and containers, and it's an open source tool for running automatic tests. It's available in GitHub and checks, basically what it does is checking for many configurations that comes by default when we are running Docker, and it shows a report where we can see what are the configuration that we must to review for running the Docker container in a more secure way. In this script capture, we can see that we are running. It shows warnings related with the memory user, usage, the CPU. We can see also that we are running our container with the read only, and in a first view we can see that if our Docker container can be a problem or not, and can be useful for a first point of view. We have also other tools like Linux. Linux is not a specific of Docker, but it has an option for auditing our Docker file. Basically, Linux is a Unix security auditing for a system hardening tool that includes that option. And in a easy way, we can see the state of our Docker daemon, what are the containers that are running, what are unus, file permissions, if we have enabled specific options like RR, more say Linux, it shows us information in this report. Well, regarding the security pipeline, when we are working with Docker, we can have this view of the pipeline. Now, basically, we are working in our machine, and we have our source repository with a with a GitHub repository, for example, and we can have, for example, a continuous integration server like Jenkins, for example, for building, testing, and package that that image before push that image to the Docker registry, for example. And in this way, we can ensure that the image are tested and packaged in a more reliable and security way. We can we have many solutions like Jenkins, TeamCity, Bamboo, depending what the project or our project configuration. We can use very continuous integration tools for allowing this process. Regarding continuous thread, basically when we are running our Docker image on in the Docker container, we must to be we must be careful with this kind of threads that can be for example, kernel exploits like the dirty code exploit, depending we have updated our kernel, these exploits, it will function or not. We can have also vulnerabilities like the GDC, buffer overflow, that we can see in some image, for example, if we download an image, for example, the Python image, it has these vulnerabilities because it has a GDC version vulnerability. And others, threats like SQL injection or MongoDB and Elasticsearch ransomware attacks. Well, this is for remember. And finally, commenting the main auditing containers image that we have in the Docker ecosystem. With these tools, basically, we can scan our image from known vulnerabilities. We have the Docker Security Scanning, that is the tool that is using the Docker Hub for analyzing the image. In basically, what it does is analyze the image for detecting vulnerabilities in binaries, in package. And what it does is compare these binaries with the CVE database, the common vulnerabilities and exposures database, for scanning the validation of the image. This is an example. We can see that we are analyzing an image and we detect that some components have specific vulnerabilities because of the versions that is using that image. For example, the JLibC that I commented before is a threat for if we find this problem can be a critical threat in when we are working with that image. Also, we have another solutions like Anchor Open Source Engine. This provides a solution for scanning also vulnerabilities in our image. It detects the vulnerability package, what is the fix, and more information related with the package that the image is running. And finally, we're commenting what are the main startups that we have in general in containers that have these startups basically will provide a solution in the cloud for managing the threat, the vulnerabilities that have in our image. And that's all. Thank you.
questions.